Hey y'all, welcome to Astronaut. So let's talk about stellar interiors. Some of the most important parameters for characterizing a star include its pressure, temperature, and composition. Today we're talking a bit about all three. I feel like an astronaut in what you know about rolling down in the deep. The total pressure in a star consists of pressure from ions, electrons, and radiation. Pressure from ions and electrons can be treated as an ideal gas, so let's start by talking about how to model gas pressure. If you have taken any sort of physics course, you are probably already familiar with the ideal gas law, PV equals NKT. P stands for pressure, V for volume, N for the number of particles, T for temperature, and K is just a constant. We can reformat this by dividing volume from both sides of our equation to get P equals NKT. Now, this N just represents the number of particles per unit volume. Number density relates to mass density as n equals rho over mu times m, where mu is the mean molecular weight. So 1 over mu is equal to mn over rho. Stellar composition is exactly what it sounds like, the stuff a star is composed of. This largely consists of hydrogen and helium. Astrophysicists refer to everything else as a metal, which I know, sounds ridiculous to anyone who's a chemist. But for the sake of characterizing the universe by and large, grouping heavier elements together is a sufficient way to differentiate between small and large stars. The mass fraction of each of these elements, that is, the ratio of the stellar mass that the element takes up, is as easy as ABC, or rather, XYZ. X is equal to the mass of hydrogen times the number of hydrogen over the mass density. Y is equal to the mass of helium times the number of helium over the mass density. And Z is equal to the mass of the metals times the number of metals over the mass density. You get the idea. The number density of each element can be found by adding the total number density of the nuclei with the total number density of electrons. For hydrogen, the number density from both nuclei and electrons is X times the density over the mass of hydrogen. The number density of helium is Y times density over the mass of helium, which we can rewrite as Y times density over 4 times the mass of hydrogen, since the mass of helium is about 4 hydrogen masses. Since the helium atom has 2 electrons, the number density is 2 times Y times the density over 4 times the mass of hydrogen. The number density of metal nuclei is Z times the density over A times the mass of hydrogen, where A is the atomic weight. We can find the number density of electrons by multiplying this by A over 2. Assuming A is sufficiently greater than 1, the number density of a metal nuclei is negligible. Substituting these terms in for mu, the total number density becomes rho over the mass of hydrogen times 2x plus 3/4 y plus 1/2 z, and gas pressure becomes rho over mh times 2x plus 3/4 y plus 1/2 z times kt. Another form of pressure is radiation pressure, which is defined by 1/3 a times t to the 4th power, where a is the radiation constant equal to 7.565 e to the negative 16th joules per meters cubed per kelvin to the 4th power. We can solve for where these two pressures are equal by setting gas pressure equal to radiation pressure. From here, we can solve for temperature. We can calculate the gas and radiation pressure at the sun's core by plugging in known values. The sun has a core temperature of 15 million Kelvin and density of 160 grams per centimeters cubed. Its composition is 34% hydrogen, 64% helium, and 2% metal. Note, this composition is specific to the sun's core and does not match its surface composition. If we plug in all these values, we can find the gas pressure is then 1.59 e to the 16th pascals, and the radiation pressure is about 1.28 e to the 13th pascals. If we compare the radiation pressure to the gas pressure at the core of the sun, we find that the ratio of radiation pressure to gas pressure is about 8 e to the negative 4th. Clearly, gas pressure dominates in the sun's core. In general, gas pressure tends to dominate in small stars, while radiation pressure becomes more applicable in massive stars. As in the previous example, if one pressure is significantly larger than the other, we can use the non-negligible pressure as an approximation for the star's total pressure. All right, that's all for today. I know it's a lot of equations today, so thanks for watching, and as always, ponder, wander, and go right in the stars. In slow motion, yeah.